Hey there, welcome back to American Truck Simulator. And as you can see, got a slightly different truck this time. I couldn't figure out the sound problems with the Freightliner cab over, so I switched to this cab over. This is the Kenworth K100, and it seems to be working completely fine. So I kind of set it up the way I wanted it. I traded the other one in and got this one. Now, unfortunately, or fortunately, I guess, all the parts are unlocked, so fortunately for me, the unfortunate part is the truck costs like $40,000, and I guess maybe that would be realistic because the truck isn't actually new. I don't think they've made a K100 in a long time, probably since the 80s, 70s, 80s. Cab overs kind of went out of style some time ago. I think they look good, but it's just not something that you see a lot of anymore. So it's one of those things that the truck itself is actually old. The model is old. They don't make them. And when you go to buy it in the truck, I guess the price reflects that. But the game doesn't model that you're getting an old truck with, you know, a lot of miles on it. So you get a new truck with 0 miles on it and whatever engine, you know, you want. I don't know exactly what was historically available, but I went with what I wanted to, what I liked, which was the CAT 3406, if I'm not mistaken. So, we can look at the the truck here. And I think I went ahead and done the rest stop. So, I got 13 hours before I have to hit the next rest stop. So, let's just turn that off. And as you can see, the park brake is animated, but the other things do not seem to be animated. But that's okay. Quit popping up. Go away. Shoot. As far as I can tell, there is no animation anywhere in this truck for the jake. And I'm not entirely sure if the differential lock works on it or not, which isn't a big deal. I'm not going to keep this one. This isn't my goal truck. It's just I wanted a truck that I could customize and have the way I wanted it until I could get the truck that I actually want where everything is part locked. So I'm going to jump out here and get a pick a load to go pick up. I just wanted you to see it and, you know, get a look inside here before we get started. Here's the outside of it. I do actually have a beacon, and I don't remember how to turn that thing on. I've got it on here somewhere. See, there's my flashers. I don't know how to remember. I don't remember. I'll figure it out. But when I come back, I'll have that figured out. So I'll be back as soon as I have something to pick up. Okay, and what we got here is a trailer full of gravel. It was literally the only thing I could find that wasn't going to like 5 miles away. Like pick it up and drive it 5 miles down the road and drop it off. This is the only thing I could find. I'm not exactly a fan of the gravel trailers, but we'll check it out and see how it goes. So this next little bit, I think until we get out on the road, I may not talk much for the first little bit. This truck sounds so much better. And if I could like bury my face in the sound that this truck makes, I would do it. I'd listen to it all day long because I think it just sounds so good. I think the sounds in the game are really good and the sounds of this truck are really good. I wish the sounds of the game were better, more like, you know, some of the videos or you see on YouTube or in real life, but it's pretty good. Just for reference, a job I used to work at actually would they bring in heavy haul, these big buildings, they would bring them in to work, and there was a truck there, and I swear I still think about it, talk about it to this day, as you're going to see. It was a Peterbilt. I think it was somewhere around like a 2002 model, you know, long nose, and he had 8-inch straight pipes on it, and I don't remember which exactly model that he had, but I asked him, and I know it was a Caterpillar engine. And that thing, I'm telling you, if you were standing next to it, you could feel it start. It was so loud. It sounded so good. It was an amazing truck. He had done a lot of work to it, and it was a really good-looking truck. It sounded good. You know, it looked good. It's a really nice truck. So anyway, I'm going to quit talking about that truck, and you can watch me drive this truck. Oh, by the way, the park brake is animated, but the trailer brake is apparently not animated, because that's the trailer brake. Right there. And I don't think we need the super low gears. One should suffice. So I'm going to be quiet. You can listen to the truck. So anyway, I really like the way the truck sounds. And other than that little boo-boo I had back there when I went to three, when I meant to actually stay in four, the truck sounds pretty good. And it goes through the gears fairly easy, I think, anyway. Whoops. There we go. So, looks like the speed limit's 80. And we're already rolling about 65, looks like, down there. Hard to see. I think 65 is an excellent speed. Now, I might actually go down to 60. I don't know. I'd rather traffic go on around me and leave plenty of space than be running the same speed as traffic and end up in a situation where somebody passes me and then cuts over way too close. And that way it leaves a little extra cushion, because you really got to watch the AI on this game, I'm telling you. You know, that car probably moved a little too close for me, and you got to kind of keep your eyes ahead, maybe more so than normal, especially even normal everyday car and truck. It takes a little bit longer to stop this since it's quite a bit heavier. And see, that other truck in the other episode, that Freightliner, I don't know, I'm not sure if maybe something on my end is wrong, but the wheel just, it seemed very floaty. I don't know how else to describe it. It had a lot of floaty feeling to the wheel, which was odd, because this wheel in this truck, I mean, it feels fine. You know, I'm using the T500 and it's spot on, it's perfect. It doesn't feel floaty or loose or anything like that. But anyway, we're just cruising along here, and this is probably my favorite part of American Truck Simulator, because, you know, we're in high gear, we're in eight, high split, we're rolling down the highway. I'm going to slow down a little. This traffic is getting bunched up there. It makes me nervous. But we're in high gear, we're rolling down the highway, and, you know, if I wasn't recording, I would definitely be listening to some music. Got a little bit of a hill, putting a little bit of strain on it. That was a pretty good slowdown there. That's a pretty good little hill to pull. This trailer isn't exactly light. Of course, this isn't, you know, the biggest engine that the truck carries. There's a couple bigger, if I'm not mistaken. This was about the middle of the line. I don't really like going, you know, with some of the crazy stuff that you see. Like, it wanted something like 700 or 800 horsepower, you know, like 5,000 foot-pounds of torque. Eh, I don't think so. I think, you know, the 450, 500, 550, maybe even 600 mark is right about probably the limits that you're going to get. At least in a non-modified truck, you're going to go buy it off the, I don't know, sure, I could just be completely wrong. But I feel like, you know, 600 is probably the upper limit that you're just going to go out and buy it. And it's going to come that way, and it's going to be that way from the factory. I really don't see, you know, anything much more than 600 from the factory. I don't know. Maybe there were a few cases where there was, you know, over 600, but I feel like that's about the area that you would usually get. Of course, you know, the horsepower isn't as big a concern as how much torque is it putting out. You know, torque is what really matters when you're moving a couple thousand pounds, 30, 40, 50,000 pounds. I thought we were getting off here, but it looks like the GPS says we're staying on. We'll keep riding on a truck. This is an enjoyable game, you know. And it's a lot like Farming Simulator in the way that it's an enjoyable game. Because there's not somebody trying to kill me, and I'm not trying to kill somebody else. And I'm not trying to make a high score or score the most points. I just pick what I want to, you know, take. I pick something I find interesting. Let's slow down a little bit more. I pick something I find interesting, and I take it. I just pick it up and drive and take it where it's supposed to go, and it's peaceful, and there's no competition, and I'm not in a hurry. It's just a real relaxing game. It's something I can come home, and if I've had a bad day or things have been busy, you know, I can just come home and say, well, I don't feel like, you know, being in a competitive state, much like Farming Simulator. Maybe I just want to play and enjoy myself. You know, even something like, say, Battle Brothers, because I've been playing Battle Brothers, or even Kerbal Space Program. Like, you get in a situation like, say, in Kerbal Space Program where I'm trying to launch a new rocket, or I'm trying to perform something, or maybe I've got an objective or mission in my head that I want to put into the game and perform, and things don't go wrong, and I get frustrated because I can't figure out what's wrong. Well, there's none of that here. Or, you know, like in Battle Brothers, you go into a battle, and, you know, maybe you've had somebody that's been there, maybe you're one of the first people that you brought into your mercenary company, and he gets killed. You know, that's part of the game. That makes the game exciting. It builds tension. But it's also can be frustrating, and sometimes I just want to come home and play a game and play a game to relax. And this is one of those games that I can just come home and I turn it on, hook everything up, you know, start the game up, and now I can play and I can just have a nice relaxing time and do something that I enjoy. I don't have my CDLs, and I've never drove anything, you know, larger than a straight truck that I used to deliver for Consolidated. But I do miss it at times. I don't miss how much I had to haul, because a lot of times they put me in situations that I thought were dangerous. You know, but I need the job, so what choice did I have? But I miss, you know, just being out on the road, and you've got some place to go, and you're moving something, and somebody needs it. But when you're in the truck, you know, I didn't answer my phone, and even if it was to ring, the truck was so loud, I couldn't hear it anyway. But I'm in my truck, and nobody bothers me in the truck. It's just me, and the radio, and the truck. And this is about the closest thing I can get to it while still being able to sit in my pajamas at the house playing video games, right? So anyway, as customary, I hope you're having a good day. And if you're not having a good day, I hope this video cheers you up. And I hope that tomorrow gets better for you, because you can't let the bad times get you down. You know, my day, it's been okay. It was a little bit busy at work, and it seems like time kind of went by fairly quickly. But nothing real major at work going on. But the most exciting thing that's happened today is I ate too much and I'm fat. So, you know, take that for what you will. I should probably quit eating so much and not being so fat. But I sure like to eat, which is my own fault, you know. But you're not here to listen to me complain about eating too much and being fat. You're here to enjoy some gameplay, right? So I think, since I don't really have anything to talk about, I don't want to ramble on about basically nothing for the next little bit, I'm just going to probably just shut up here and let you enjoy watching the rest of the video until at least we get where we're going. So turn it up, or put some music on, or turn it up and switch the music on, or whatever you want to do. Just have a good time and enjoy the video. sometimes it's so hard to tell what that GPS wants me to do. Which is why I couldn't decide whether or not I needed to get off the highway or stay on the highway. But it's like I should have stayed on, so I did. It's too bad tunnels didn't actually make a difference in the audio. But, you know, maybe in future alliterations and updates. Let's get out of this guy's way here. He's wanting to get on the highway. If you keep hearing something click, that's the easy jake on my SKRS shift knob. And I think we're clear. That guy's pretty way far back there, I think. But if you keep hearing something click, 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 that's just the easy jake switch on the shift knob. It's kind of loud. So anyway, I actually have something pretty exciting to talk about, and you'll probably get to see the other video, the one I'm actually pretty excited to make. I'm hoping to work on it tonight. Tonight is actually Thursday night, but you may not actually see this video until either Saturday or Sunday. A lot of times, I pre-record the videos and try to cave 2 to 3 days ahead, just in case I have a day where I don't feel good and I don't feel like recording, or if something happens and I can't record. So I'm hoping nothing happens and I get to bring hopefully some new content that I've been looking forward to, you know, for a long time, here soon, hopefully tonight. And what it is, which by the time that you watch this video, it'll probably be out. What it actually is iRacing. Hang on a minute. Okay, iRacing has finally brought out their dirt track cars and tracks. And I'm really excited about it. Like this morning, I was so excited about it, I was showing everybody at work. I'm probably sure that I annoyed the crap out of them. Pull in for a vehicle inspection. I can't even see where the vehicle, it must be up here. Ah, it's up here. But you can't see nothing. Really? Just cut me off there, guy. Whatever. Like you didn't see me. Anyway, back to what I was talking about. iRacing finally released their dirt track cars. Now, I didn't know anything about it. I'd actually forgotten about it since it had been so long since I seen the initial announcement. I just figured it'd be a pipe dream. And in my opinion, there hasn't been a good dirt track racing game probably since Dirt Track Racing 2. I think there was another game called maybe like Saturday Night Lights. And maybe there was Saturday Night Lights 1 and 2. I could be wrong on the name, but I remember another game that wasn't Dirt Track Racing 1 or 2, and I remember that it was Dirt Track 1, Dirt Track Racing 1, and Dirt Track Racing 2 weren't bad games, but they were several years ago, either in the late 90s or the early 2000s, and technology has changed a lot since then. You know, even the past couple years, technology's changed a lot. And there just hasn't been a good dirt track racing game in years. Probably at least since maybe 2002, if not longer. And I'm really, really excited about it. Like, that's what I thought about all day at work. you know, why does it work? And I was like, oh man, check this out. And I showed everybody. And then, you know, when I went on lunch, that's what I watched. I watched videos of other people playing. And I absolutely can't wait to try it. Now, right now, it's downloaded. And of course, if you don't know what iRacing is, it's basically a subscription. Much like you would pay, say, World of Warcraft or, you know, Final Fantasy 15. I think it's 15. Basically, it's got an MMO-style subscription. And, you know, more months you buy, the cheaper it is. And in my opinion, I play a lot. I play the Assetto Corsa. I've got Automobilista. I've got Game Stock Car Extreme. I've got Project Cars. I've got a lot of games. I've played a lot of games. But I've got a lot of games. I've played a lot of racing games. And even all this time, after all these games that I've played, iRacing is probably the one that I have most hours on as far as a racing game. Outside of maybe Forza or Gran Turismo, which I really wish there was PC versions of. Because in my opinion, maybe not in the actual racing and physics department, but in my opinion, it's really hard to beat Forza Motorsport single player mode, simply because of the amount of cars and customization in the game. So, I don't know why, there it is. For whatever reason, the range selector on my shift knob was funky. I had to switch it up into high and then back down into low before it caught. But outside of maybe Forza, which isn't really a simulator, I'd say iRacing is just about the best there is. Now, I haven't played the new R Factor 2, but I have played R Factor. And I could have swore it said to turn right, and then it changed its mind. I guess I'm about to find out if it doesn't turn me around here. I probably looked at it wrong because I got distracted because I was excited because I was talking about. I thought it did. But anyway, you know, there hasn't been a good dirt track racing game in a long time. And if those people weren't awake, they are now. But there hasn't been a good dirt track racing game in a long time, and I'm really excited to play it. And iRacing, in my opinion, bar maybe, you know, R Factor 2 that I haven't played, is probably the best simulator around. And, you know, I'm sure that there's other games that do things better than iRacing does, and there's things that iRacing does better than other games. But iRacing is a pretty good game. And I kind of wish sometimes that it had an offline mode, single player. It doesn't. I wish it did. And it is a little pricey. I got to admit, it's pricey. But years ago, I kind of regret it now. I was maybe like $50 or $60 away from being a 100% content owner. And I never did buy it because I didn't like the oval track, or not the ovals. I wasn't in the roadside, and the last few things I needed were road tracks and road cars, and I wasn't really interested. And now I think I've got like maybe 70% of the content, since so much has come out since I played. It maybe been down like 50 or 60%. I should have come the other way, because I got a feeling I can't get in there. I should have come from the other direction. I should have known better. Now I'm going to try to go all the way down and turn around and come back. But anyway, I'm pretty excited for it. I'm pretty excited to get to try it. And hopefully the download will be finished soon. So I can try it out. It's something I'm really looking forward to. And from what I've seen and from what I've read, apparently they've really got it fairly accurate. So I'm excited to see it. Which, like I said, probably by the time you see this video, I'm probably going to have a few videos of iRacing up at that point. I may not have an actual full race up, but I'll probably have, you know, like some practice runs, because I'm going to do some practice laps. I haven't played iRacing in a year or longer, you know, and maybe other than Farming Simulator and American Truck Simulator, my wheel doesn't see much use. But I know it seems like a kind of a big waste to play Farming Simulator and American Truck Simulator with a T500, which is, I guess, a mid-level wheel. It's kindly expensive. You know, the G27 I had would have been way more than enough, most likely. I actually bought the T500 because I was getting back into iRacing. And then, I don't know, it seems like the population for the classes that I wanted to race just aren't there. But right now, the dirt is like the hot thing. And it's what I was looking forward to. So I want to jump on the bandwagon while I can. Because I like racing the modifieds. I think the SK and Tour Mod are probably the best content in iRacing, in my opinion. I'm not a road course kind of guy. I like to turn left a lot. I think I run up to like C or B license on the road, and then I just decided that it wasn't for me. I didn't enjoy it. And there's nothing wrong with road racing. If you like road racing, that's fine. Road racing and oval racing are two different kinds of racing, and they each have their own challenges, and they each have their own positives and their own negatives. So I'm not saying that oval is the best and road sucks, because some people like oval and some people like road and some people like both. I'm just more of an oval person as far as actually driving. Like, if I'm going to be the one driving and doing the racing, I'm going to run in an oval. I need to turn around here. See, there it went again. It wants to put me in high range, but my selector is in low range. I need to turn around so that I can actually hit that parking spot. What did we hit? I'm confused. Like, it doesn't look like. Did I hit the fence? Yeah, I sure did. Now I'm in a pickle because that daggone truck is back right up behind me. I thought sure I cleared that. Meh. What a nub mistake. No, I actually didn't hit it. Like, there's no collision there. I'm close. But now I'm in a pickle because this dude is like jammed right up behind me, and I'm not going to be able to do much. I might just crank it hard left and see if I can. Like, that should be clear. There wasn't a collision there. There was going to be a collision there. Ah, I see. Must have been hung on that building over there. But that building looks like it was higher. Yeah, there shouldn't have been a problem there. I don't know. I'm going to chalk that up to wonky collision somewhere. Maybe I hit something and I missed it and I don't see it. But sometimes the game thinks things stick out farther than they actually do, which is why I don't use the oversized trailer mods. Let's see if we can get a turn around right here. Ah, there we go. But I'm pretty excited for it. I can't wait to try it out. But, the reason I quit iRacing, it seems like every time that I quit iRacing, it's the same reason that I quit iRacing the last time. Is I either get frustrated because you get people who don't take it seriously. Like, you get people who just jump in a race, and they don't practice with their cars, and they don't have a setup, and they don't care. And they just jump out on the track. And they ruin my time, because a lot of times these official races, because I like to race in the official races, a lot of times in the official races I only may get time to do one, maybe two at most, of some of the other classes, because the time schedules form and the participation numbers are so low. So if I get one race a night, and that's all I get time for, you know, I get to put in some practice laps, and then I get that one race, and then somebody comes in and they don't care, and I get tangled up in it, you know, in a wreck, or they take you out on purpose, or hit you or knock you off the track or something, and it takes it out of my hands, which I know a lot of times in iRacing, if you step back and look, there may, you know, well, you could have done this and you could have done that, but sometimes if somebody's just out to get you, they, there's not much you can do about it. Like, you can't stop somebody from purposely running into your back bumper or slamming you in the side or anything. That was pretty good. I floated that right in there. No clutch needed. So that worked out pretty good. But I'm, you know, I feel like 90% of the time when an accident happens, it's probably, you know, my fault. I'm not saying I'm a bad driver. My safety rating in iRacing is actually pretty good. And I'm, if I remember right, I am, I'm A-rated on ovals. So I'm A-licensed on oval. I got to talking and missed my gear shift. That's all right. The light's red and we'll just roll to a stop. I'm A-rated on oval, and I'm either C or B on road. But you get, you know, like I said, you get somebody and they don't take it seriously, which in the end, it's a game. But, you know, if I get one race a night and I get into that race and then somebody does something and, you know, maybe there's a wreck or something and I can't avoid it, and but the wreck itself could have been avoided, or somebody got mad and they took out somebody else, it's one of those situations where, you know, I can't. Oh, come on, buddy, really? Yeah, honk at me there, because I gotta back up. Yeah, that's what I do. You're, nah, blow it out your nose. Blow it out your nose. That's totally what I was gonna say. Really? American Truck Simulator fully simulates traffic of an everyday basis. Right? I can't see a thing. I feel like I may be past this guy. I don't know. I'm gonna have to pop out here and check it out. Okay, I'm past him. Night time is a difficult time to make deliveries, especially when you got that guy. Like, he's run right up on me. And I know I had my flashers on. I think I just ran over one of those markers. Now I'm flustered. There. Yeah, just go on. You know, thanks a lot. Like, he should have known better, right? Like, he's driving a truck. He should have known better than to do that. You know, I come down through here and I turn my flashers on, then you run right up behind me and leave me no room to go anywhere or do anything. That's real classy, real professional. Of course, it'd help if I could actually concentrate and get unflustered and get the trailer in there instead of have to see. I got daggone. Did I run over it again? I think I did. Yeah, I've shoved that one out of the way. We'll just chalk this delivery up to I did an extremely bad job here. I had bad luck all the way around. It's dark, I can't see. Well, at least the only thing I hit was that little barrier. And I guess at least the best thing about it being dark and so late at night is there's nobody else around, right? It's really hard to see what's going on. There's no work lights up here, and I can't see nothing. I can't see a thing. Now I'm way off. So this has turned out excellent. Let's get pulled up here and get straightened out. Let's put the brake on and pop out here and see. So I don't usually like using the outside view unless I'm stopped in a park. Like if I just, you know, like you would stop and get out and look, which I don't think there's anything wrong with. You know, when I was delivering for Consolidated, I'd often, you know, leave it running but put the brake on, and I would get out and look. Because it's better to get out, look, and take a few extra minutes to see what you're doing and plan things out than to get in a hurry and tire things up. Because once you've broken it or hit it or run over it or damaged it, it's damaged. But if you'd have took, you know, 2 seconds to get out and look and see what was going on, then you probably could have avoided the situation. Yeah, I know, low air. So I guess I'm gonna sit here until the air runs back up, right? We can turn that off. We can turn this off. Where is the air gauge on this? So anyway, I think I'm gonna end the video here. I had a fairly successful trip down here, and then the last little bit everything seemed to go wrong. So I'll leave you with that. I hope you have a good day. I hope you had a good time watching the video. If you liked the video, you know, leave me a thumbs up. Tell me what you liked about it. If you didn't like it, leave me a thumbs down. Tell me what you didn't like about it. And as always, if you want to see more, please subscribe. If you don't want to subscribe, I guess you can just look up my name or keep an eye out for any videos. But thank you for watching, and I hope you have a good day, and I'll see you next time. And keep the shiny side up. Boy, that come out wrong. The shiny side up. Yeah. Keep the wheels on the rubber. Or wait a minute. Yeah. I'll probably just cut that out. Or maybe I'll just leave it in because I'm tripping over myself. I'll see you next time, okay?